Westminster Magistrates Court, unfortunately, any type of system of justice doesn't actually, the word justice may as well be excluded. We could also call them the Ministry of Injustice, but depending on which way you see it, at the moment there's a lot of planets in Sagittarius, and Sagittarius is often thought of as the sign that represents justice. Julian has some planets which may be opposing Sagittarius kind of justice, but justice is in this case the real justice, the justice or the human justice, rather than the one that's been legalized, as in put into a set of rules made by humans, and or which may also involve corruption, which may also have been adapted to the material world to what is possible to implement. So sometimes these things like incarceration or removal of rights, maybe you may say it's for the general good, whilst the people who do it say it's for the general good, but actually it might be just to save money in some other area, or to have an ulterior motive or a second agenda, hidden agenda. We don't want poor Julian to be as a case set for the future for other people to have to go through the same thing. And he's been shown as an example to stop other people doing things that would be construed as using up taxpayers' money, or making things more difficult for the system to work. But in any case, what he has said are things that should be left to the open. There's been a lot of his life has been basically destroyed, and nobody should be incarcerated for these reasons. Everybody should have freedom to say what they like. Unfortunately, so when I say what they like, I mean, you know, to a certain extent. But I do think that he's been put as a scapegoat. There is a Gemini Sagittarius opposition, obviously, at the moment. And he, I think, has quite a few planets in Gemini, with the Pluto, forceful Plutonian way of speaking from the 1971 generation of saying, trying to say the truth and get underneath the surface. So it's not his fault he is the way he is. And also, you can see a lot of politicians are Gemini, like, for example, on the day of the elections, we had Jeremy Corbyn, we have Donald Trump, we have even the winner of the election is a Gemini. I won't say his name. He is a Gemini. Obama's a Gemini. JFK is a Gemini. So there was a full moon and super moon in Gemini, highlighting communication issues and highlighting people who are Geminis, making see, so we can all see their vulnerabilities. I think that Boris Johnson was in the right place at the right time. 6 years down the line, the next election isn't going to go like that. Eventually we're going to see a global shift. Maybe he's going to try out what he wanted to try out. We're going to see it's not working and everything's going to change. I'm not saying I've anything against the Tories or against Labour in particular, but I'm just reflecting what I think I can see in the astrology for the future. Everything, the whole world is going to have to readapt in a way, and this is why it's important that on this particular day we understand that it isn't fair to be trying to pick out people who are doing what should be done anyway to rectify the issues, and making them scapegoats and examples for the public to see. I mean, I even feel sorry for Jeremy Corbyn, obviously. It's not his fault. He was vilified by the newspapers. You know, you say these things and then they sound like they were truths. The same with Julian Assange. He might not have had anything to do with anything with these women in Sweden. We don't know. I mean, how come they didn't make a big issue about Boris Johnson and his little tete-a-tete with his pole dancer? So anyway, the point is I'm going to go now, that you can see Julian. If you can't see him in real person, you can still see him on my YouTube and my little film called The Green Ken, which discusses energy fields and how they all blend. of the stick on SoundCloud, Laika Space Dog, SPACEDOG, and Laika is LAIKA, and play them on the radio. And that's called the wrong end of the stick. Thank you very much and goodbye. Nice talking to you. Or listening to you. Listening to me, rather.